Hi, it's Chris from Web Motor Works. I'm just giving you an update on our small block Chevy electric crate motor. Now, last time you saw, we were getting ready to cast everything. I've got everything back from the casting. I've welded everything together now. This is, of course, hollow. Right here we have our electric fan that's going to blow air down or up in the engine to help with some cooling. And then we're also going to have cooling here and here. Normally you can have a water pump on the front. I've got a water bypass. It's a little bit cleaner look. And I actually have a small electric water pump inside the motor itself. This is our intake manifold, which looks more or less like a small block Chevy. A little bit bigger carburetor, of course, but you get the idea. You could actually, if you wanted, put the fan down below and have your carburetor set up if you wanted it to look like a stock motor. Same as your headers, you could hook your headers onto it, whatever you want. This is a alternator, so your stock alternator and all your wiring you can hook up. Normally a Tesla, they don't have that, but the plan for this is if you have a Corvette or a Camaro or something, you can just bolt this right in. We have the engine mounts all set in the exact same position. So we've got our dual 35 motor here. These are the high tension cables. They hook up onto the controllers. Controllers are going to sit on this heat sink here. This heat sink goes inside. I've got a little water pump here. And controllers are actually little computers. They go there. And then the water circulates through here. And got a little bit more wiring to do in there. And then at the back here, our transmission is going to bolt onto here. There's a coupler there, which the clutch will hook onto. And hopefully if all goes well, we'll be putting it in this 36 Hayes here. So I've already pulled the motor out and probably do a little bit of cleanup in here, but more or less just pop her in and away we go.